Hello, good morning, students. Welcome to my channel, Smart Coding by Shoykot Banerjee. It includes various concepts on various programmings, nodes, and complete solutions of questions for beginners and ICSE students. Okay, so today's topic includes two things mainly: use of static and non-static, use of static non-access modifier. Programs will be shown to you with an example. So static is a non-access modifier. So let's start with this concept. Look here in the screen. Our first question arises in the mind: why do we need a static variables? So static variables are used for memory management or to efficiently use the memory. We know that static is a non-access modifier. There are many other non-access modifier, but in your syllabus there is a static non-access modifier which you need to know. So if the question comes in the exam, what is the use of static non-access modifier? The only to the point answer is it is used for efficient memory management technique, or it is used for efficient memory management or to efficiently use the memory. Okay, so let's see the next part over here. For example, suppose I'll show you why it is important to use a static non-access modifier. Suppose there is a class employee. An employee has their own ID, EMP ID. They have their string name, because companies are called TCS. A TCS company has its own employees, and employees have their own ID. It's a media type name, that is your string type. Company name is suppose TCS. Three instance variables are declared over here. Instance variable belong to an object, as I've said in the last video. Now, what happens here is, I'm using a constructor. Just as of now, you just keep in mind, constructor is a special method, which will be taught in the one more chapter is the constructor chapter is there. I'll be teaching in that. Constructor, here, three parameters are passed here. As because parameters are passed here, it is a parameterized constructor, which I'll tell you later on in detail in constructor chapter. Now ID, name one, and comp one are three parameters passed in this employee function. Here employee is a constructor. It should be same as class name. See, employee has a class name, same as here also. Now what happens here is, after that we are assigning this parameter. We are assigning this parameter ID to EMP ID. That means value will be accepted by these parameters. By method call, when the object will be created, then the value of ID will be assigned to instance variable EMPID. That means this ID is for EMPID, name one for name, comp one for company. You can see over here. Just to assign the values to this instance variable, to this three instance variable. Clear? Now suppose of this company called TCS there are several employees. Now what we will do? We have to print these values. So again, we have a display method, which you can see over here. Display method I have declared over here to print the values of print EMPID, name and company. Is it clear? This will be very clear. See, I'm rewinding back. That is a class employee having three instance variables. Suppose employee's company name is suppose TCS. Now we are using a constructor over there to initialize the instance variable, to assign some values. Initialize means to assign some values. So this ID for this EMPID, name one for name, and comp one for company. Through constructor, we are assigning values to this instance variable using constructors. Okay. Now, display method to print the output in the screen. Now from the main method, as you can see, we are creating an object of employee class. Suppose one employee is E1. And I'm passing the parameters, actual parameters here. 101, omit, and TCS. Now, once this is done, one more object we are creating here, E2, and we are displaying that. Now, in this code, what happens is 101, omit, and TCS will be passed to here. You can see 101 will be passed to ID. then name one Amit will pass to here and TCS will pass to here. From here, it will be assigned to this instance variables. Clear? Now, what is the problem here? Problem is, let me show you the problem, why we need static variables. In the above example shown in the previous slide, the output will be this one. If you run that program shown in the previous slide, the output will be this one. This is the output. Now, what happens here is, suppose in a company TCS there are 1000 of employees. So you are creating 1000 of objects, E1, E2, E3, E4, dot, 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 E1000s. Now, each employee have their own unique ID and different name in a company. Suppose in a classroom, all students have different roll number and different name, same in company also. But the company name or school name is same. Secretary Hart School is the same school or same company TCS. Now, in the main method section, there are two objects created for class employee. I have shown you in the previous slide. Each object will have their own values assigned. That is, this one, 101 Amit TCS for object E1, and this one for object E2. Now, once these objects are created, memory space will be allocated for each objects, as shown in the next slide diagrammatically. Let's move to the next slide. See, E1, E2, dot, 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 suppose 1000 employees are there of the same company. So see, for each instance variable company, every time it is created, memory space will be allocated for this company also, because each time the object is created, memory space will be allocated separately for each time for this also, which is not convenient. It is wasting the memory space. EMPID name is different. It has to be different of all the employees in a company. But company name is same. Each time you are creating object for this instance variable company equal to TCS, it is allocating a separate space every time. So that is a wastage of memory. So to make this fix, to sort out this ambiguity, we can use static variables. So let's see the next slide. In the previous slide, shown objects EMPID name will be different, but the company name will be same. But the problem is, each time object is created, it will allocate space in the every time for company name through value, though the value is same, which is not efficient memory utilization. In the previous slide, once again I'm telling, EMPID name will be different, but the company name will be same. But the problem is, each time object is created, E1, E2, E3, it will allocate space every time for company name also, though the value is same, which is not efficient memory utilization. Company name is same, TCS. For that also, it's every time allocating the memory, which is a wastage. To solve this problem, we can make instance variable company as static. That is shown here, next. Once static is declared, it will allocate a separate memory for company name one time only. And every time when the objects are created, all the objects will share it. This is how the memory will be effectively used. Let us show you with the program once again. Class employee. Now, these are the instance variable. Now see, let me show you the full code first. We are using a constructor and a display method over here. Now see what happens over here. These two have the different values, has to be a different value, EMPID name. But company name, I'm assigning the value over here itself only. While declaring this instance variable company, I'm assigning the value here only, making it static, making it fixed. So one time the separate memory will be allocated for this static variable or a class level variable. This is a company's a class level variable now, or a static variable, which belongs to the class employee. Okay. Now, one time the memory will be allocated, and every time the objects will be created, it will be shared. Okay, now, one more concept is, we are using this constructor here to assign the values of EMPID name. Now, see, I have used this keyword written in small letter. This means, it is a keyword which is used to point the current instance variable of a class. Suppose, EMPID and name. And here also parameter pass same thing, EMPID and name, which will be a conflict. to make it to differentiate these two things, that instance variable and these parameters, we use a this keyword. This dot emptyid means this emptyid is for this one, this instance variable. So this one, this part is pointing to this instance variable, and this dot name points to this one. As the names are same here, that's why we are using this keyword here to differentiate and to avoid the conflicts. Display method, you know, students, it is to print the values of emptyid name and company. Now let us move on to the next slide. Now from the main method, what you are doing here is creating an object of the employee class, passing two values over here. One value I have taken already there as a static fix. Now we are printing the calling the display method by using an object e1.display. We are creating another object passing two parameters, 102 and Ajay, and we are calling the display method. So what happens here is static variables are used to refer to the common property or value for all objects, which can be more clear to you by the diagram here. See, separate class area in the class area. Static variables are defined in the class area. Keep in mind, in a stack area, all the reference variables are there. E1, E2 are the reference variable, which is pointing to some object in the heap area. This is what is a heap area. And this is a stack area. And this is a class area. Static variables are created in the class area. Reference variables are created in the stack area. And E1 is pointing to some objects in the heap area. So E1 is pointing to this, and E2 is pointing to this. Now, one time only memory will be allocated for this one, because it is static. Company is static now, as per the latest code I have shown in the previous slide. So as this is static, one time the memory will be allocated by this one in the class area, by company in a company instance variable in a class area. And every time this reference are created, it will be shared. This class area will be shared by the objects. Every time this reference variables are created in the by using a new operator in a stack area, these objects, E1 is pointing to suppose this object. So this will be shared. This will share this company variable, instance variable. Sorry, company static variable every time. Suppose E2, this is for E2. Suppose E3 is also there. E3 will also share this. That means separately we are not allocating memory for company, as because it is static now. Because we require this every time, but the value will remain fixed. That's why you have made this a static variable. I hope it is clear to you students by these diagrams. If any doubt, do comment in the YouTube comment sections. And if this video is useful for you all, then please do like it, comment it, subscribe it, and click on the bell icon to get the more videos. Thank you. Take care.